Yeah, good evening, everyone. Hopefully, everybody is still awake. So I already got introduced here quite well. So just to say, like, I'm working actually in the graphics group, but also I'm dangerous enough to also work with CPUs. And what I want to tell you about today is actually in my like other role, which is like being part of the HSA Foundation and being the workgroup chair for the system architecture. So this HSA or heterogeneous system architecture is something that you may have not heard about, but I think after the lightning talk, you might not know about it and hopefully be more interested. So where is compute used today? It's pretty much everywhere, right? And being able to do computations faster with less power is pretty much everywhere where you put in software. So if you see, for example, smartphones or like high-performance computers, etc., each one has heterogeneous designs where you have an accelerator with general-purpose CPUs in there. And so this is already here. The problem is how to program these things. So well, hardware is there. You have CPU cores, GPU cores, other accelerators in there that do the work and that connect you to memory. Oop, what happened here? Yep, there you go. This is like all done on the system platform level. What HSA is about is like making it much easier for the software to actually take advantage of this, because it's really hard to program otherwise, at least today. So the early focus of the HSA architecture was on GPUs, but it can actually deal with a lot of other computational accelerators. And this is DSPs, FPGAs, and whatever else you can imagine in your software to be usable. How do we make it better? So we make it easier to program. It's pretty much one source for all. It's easier to optimize because you only have to deal with one source code, with one system in essence. And ultimately you will get higher performance and you will get lower power for it. So there's a lot of questions about what is it with OpenCL and HSA and whatnot. So it's not really antagonistic or mutually exclusive. It's about like OpenCL being HSA being a good foundation for OpenCL, not that they are in any way mutually exclusive. HSA is focused mostly on standards, in the hardware side or in the platform side, but with some runtime API to do the resources, but not as a runtime API like OpenCL, where you actually have to use the API to dispatch things. And it supports many more languages than like a C style or C++. There's, for example, implementations of Python and other high-level languages that directly target the hardware. So, but OpenCL itself actually benefits from a rich foundation that the platform provides. And, well, HSA is typically a little bit different to program. So what we do? We have created a platform architecture that integrates all the different types of accelerators, GPU, CPU, and everything in there. It's focused on compute, but other accelerators can play in there. That doesn't dictate any particular architecture. Many different architectures are available. And it provides a robust foundation for programming. It empowers mainstream programmers, making it easier to write code in high-level languages. It supports a broad range of platforms. And pretty much a lot of data parallel runtimes that you are already familiar with. This is like not an AMD effort per se. There are many other companies involved, as you can see here, and academia and both software, hardware companies, etc. The main foundation that you are actually dealing with HSA actually is what you are very familiar with, which is open source C++. Compilers, etc., or like C++ compilers in general. So Clang and LLVM has been adapted, and you can pretty much program both the CPU and the accelerators within that same framework. HCC is, for example, a package that AMD has put into open source that utilizes a fully C++ 14 compatible infrastructure that can target at the accelerator. It supports the H++ API, which is like a combination of C++ 14 and C++ AMP structures. You have a mechanism that you can use, port very easily CUDA code into it if you have already some legacy code. And of course, you can also do the C++ M1.2 standard. And OpenMP is also supported. It supports a number of different areas. And yeah, what I'm saying is,